since the beginning of time, plants have removed CO2 from the atmosphere and converted it into biomass. And what we're trying to do is use that same process to create molecules that are more useful for humans. ARPA-E's approach to biofuels is really looking at using all the tools in the toolbox. In the PETRO program, we have 10 awardees that are currently pursuing different approaches to this goal of generating high energy molecules directly in plants.
Harnessing the natural ability of pine trees to make terpenes, which is the dominant source of terpenes for industrial use today, and we're trying to advance there through genetics and genetic engineering to produce a lot more terpene to make it commercially viable for biofuels. Terpenes are a natural compound that's close to a fuel molecule, and at the end of the day, when the plant makes it, the capital cost to go to scale is much, much less. So working with the JBay team, Jim Kirby in particular, he's moved forward with their metabolic engineering, first in E. coli as well as in yeast, to improve enzyme activities and target specific ones. We've tested them and taken the best candidates and put them into pine. The preliminary results indicate that the knowledge they've gained from E. coli in particular is translating directly to pine.
So I think the advantage of the PETRO program is that it's very targeted towards a specific goal. It's a discrete project, you know, you've got a 3 or 4 year timeline, and they have very specific goals they want everybody to reach within that timeline. There's collaboration going on between the projects, and the program manager, Jonathan, is kind of overseeing everything, putting everyone together, sharing technology. If it seems like one group could benefit from sharing another person's technology. So in the case of these particular genes that we're talking about, we're putting them into pine, and as you can imagine, pine takes a long time to grow. So we've passed them on to Christer Janssen's group at LBL, working with Peggy Lemo, and they've been able to test these genes in tobacco. And that's an advantage for both groups because, number one, they get to test the genes, and number two, we get to see a faster result. So they can put them in tobacco and measure the biofuel output much more quickly than we can do in pine. Sharing the genes and sharing the technology, it gives the overall PETRO program a better chance of success.
Tobacco is really an ideal crop, that it's not just a one-time harvest. They can come in and harvest 4 or 5 times in a season. So it's a continuous source of biomass to make biofuels. One of the things that ARPA-E does is give people the opportunity to do things that are a little risky. We have very ambitious goals, and if we accomplish those goals, we believe we'll be competitive. It's really high risk, but if it works, it's a high reward, and they have built a community that allows you to do that and a program that allows you to do that.
If it's successful, I think that we will be the leader in renewable chemicals and biofuels.
We want to try to minimize the amount of pollution that's part of the existing petrochemical process.
Success really is creating a technology that's economically viable and sustainable.
If you imagine that we never have to drill another oil well, that we're growing all the fuel that we need, you have to imagine that that's going to be a tremendous benefit to society overall.